afternoon.
When?
okay. Shunu gulu jwa bo shi tu ma ra bi ji de sung mi so jam be yang la. Cha ce lo. So today we will mainly talk about the wisdom part because usually, right, we talk about the basic things first and the most important thing at the last, or maybe the most difficult to understand at the last, right? But today, I think we should try to understand the wisdom part first and the others, such as, you know, the karma and all those other practices after we talk in the next session.
那么今天呢，我们将着重于智慧这个层面的教法。一般来讲呢，我们一定都会先从最基础的开始讲起，然后我们会把比较困难的以及最重要的放在最后来讲。但是呢，今天呢，仁波切他想要先跟大家谈智慧，然后他在下一堂课呢再跟大家谈像业力啊、羞耻这一方面的。
Yes, so when Buddha attained enlightenment, there was a man, right, who saw Buddha, and instead of asking, who are you, he actually asked Buddha, what are you?
那么在释迦牟尼佛证悟之后呢，有这样的一个人，他去见了释迦牟尼佛。那呢，他首先他问佛陀的一个问题，不是在问他说你是谁，他问他说 ，What are you？ 就是你是什么
？And he asked him, "Are you God?" Right? He asked him, "Are you or a human?" And he also asked, "Are you you know, God, right? God in sense of creator of this world, right?" He asked Buddha, "Oh, are you a God? Are you an angel? Are you a human?" And Buddha responded, he said, "I'm not a human. I'm not a God. I'm not an angel. But I'm awakened one." Right? He said, I'm the awakened one," which means Buddha.
那么这个人在他问，他说他问佛陀说你是什么？你是神吗？就像一位这样子创造主、万能的神吗？还是你是天使，或者你是个人？你到底是什么？那么佛陀就回答说：“我既不是人，我也不是天使，我更不是神，但是呢，我是一位觉醒者。”
Yes, and sleeping, right? Usually, like when we are sleeping, we are missing the reality. You know, whatever we experience during the sleep, like a dream, is all fake. It doesn't exist, right? So even in our normal life, when we are sleeping, we are missing the reality. We are not seeing the truth, right? But when we are awakened, we start to see things as it is. So in Buddhism sense, right, as long as we have the ignorance, as long as we have this impure mind, we are like sleeping, you know, because it doesn't allow us to see the truth. But when you have the wisdom, it is something like awaken, because when you're awake, you start to see things, right? So in Buddhist sense, we are like sleeping right now.Because we have the ignorance, which doesn't allow us to see the truth. So, but that's why the Buddha message was you know, I'm awakened, which means that I have seen the ultimate truth, ultimate reality.
我们大家都知道，当我们在睡觉、睡梦当中呢，我们其实是没有办法清楚的了知周围的真实的一些现象，因为在睡梦当中，我们所有的梦境它其实都是虚幻的。但是呢，当我们醒过来的时候呢，我们才可以看得很清楚 ，OK， 周遭真实的状况是怎么一回事。那么其实这样就有点类似，当我们人只要我们的心还是有无明，还是有不净观染污，我们其实就见不到事情真实的状况，我们其实见不到实相的。所以说呢，当我们拥有智慧以后，它其实就是一种能够让我们照见实相，知道真实状况的，这就是智慧。所以佛陀他说他是一个觉醒者，其实他就是已经觉醒的，他是已经醒过来，他已经了知实相，也就是圣义谛，他是清楚照见一切的。
Yes, so as we all know, right, Buddha was a prince. Despite his very luxurious life, right, he left that life behind and went on to seeking the path to enlightenment. At the very beginning of, right, in seeking the truth, he practiced the practice of austerity, right, and he did that, right? He practiced that austerity because he believed that to see the truth, right, to attain enlightenment, we need to remove, right, we need to expel the causes of suffering. So at that moment, Buddha, he actually thought, he believed that the cause of suffering is our body, right? Is our body. He thought that. Because at that time, there are so many other religious practitioners who punish their body, you know, body, because they thought the cause and condition of our suffering in this life is our body, right? So he followed that path and he starved himself for almost 6-7 years, many years, right? And but eventually he realized, oh, this is not the right path, because the cause of our suffering is not our body. He realized cause of our suffering is our ignorant mind, right? So from that moment, he gave up the practice of austerity and he started to learn about the mind. He started to see the mind as the cause of all suffering.
那么我们都知道，释迦牟尼佛在他出家之前，就是在他去寻求真理之道之前，他是一位王子，他是住在皇宫当中，拥有一切奢华、荣华富贵，他的生活是非常优渥的。但是呢，他下定决心要去寻找真理，所以他离开了皇宫，抛弃一切，踏上觉醒之道。那他其实一开始的时候，释迦牟尼佛他的一个那时候悉达多太子，他其实所做的就是苦行，他其实是去修持苦行，因为呢，他觉得说要去见到真理，他觉得首先必须移除苦跟苦因。那时候他相信苦的原因其实就是因为我们这个身体，所以其实在那个时期呢，有非常多的所谓精神之道的修行者，他们都是在修持苦行，用各种各样的方式，可以说几乎像在惩罚自己的这个身体，希望能够借由此来移除苦因。但是他这样修持了6到7年多年之后，他最终终于领悟到这是不对的，其实真正会带来苦因的是我们的无明，是这一颗心。所以他从那个时候呢， 他开始听止了苦行，他才开始真正这个羞耻之道，因为他领悟到其实心才是最重要的。
Yes, so many people ask Buddhist teacher, oh Rinpoche, you know, what practice should I do? They ask a lot. Like there is no any, practice which is prescribed by Buddha and Bodhisattvas, but it is not true. I say, right, many disciples, they ask their teacher, Buddhist teacher, monk, Rinpoche, Lama, Kimbo, oh, what practices, right, I should conduct, I should do, as if they ask this question, as if there's no any clear suggestion or advice given by our master, right? But that's not true. Because Shantideva, he himself said, Simsung tulshu mato be tulshu mangbu chishi shas, right? The practices that we really need is the practice of taking care of your own mind. That is the practices, right? That is the practice that we need. Any practices other than taking care of your own mind, we don't need it anymore, as long as we can take care of our mind. Right? Shantideva said, this is very important. Practice of taking care of our own mind. That is the practice that we need. Other practice we don't need.
那么很多的学佛人或很多人，他其实就会去问佛教的这些老师，不管是堪布啊、出家众啊，或者什么切，他们常最会问的问题，问最多就是：我该做什么样的修持？我应该要怎么样子去修行？什么是我该做的？他们这样问，好像几乎就像是觉得说，佛陀没有指定一个什么修持让大家去做，其实不是这样子的。是有的，那是什么呢？就如吉天菩萨所说的，我们其实真正需要的修持，就是照顾好我们的这一颗心，照料、关照好我们的这一颗心，这是所有人都需要的修持。除此之外，你可以说其他的修持都是不需要的。最重要的，其实就是要看照好我们这一颗心。
And the reason why Shantideva said right, He has a very good reason, and he explained with one example, right? For example, when we walk, if we walk barefoot, right? There are so many sharp objects on the ground, right? So it might prick your feet, it might hurt your feet. So to solve this problem, right?We don't need to cover the whole ground, whole earth with a leather, because that's not possible. Because we don't have enough leather to cover the whole earth, right? So instead of doing that, Shantideva said, just cover your own feet. Just cover your own feet with a leather, or cover your own feet with a shoe. You don't need to cover the whole ground, whole earth. Right? So exactly like that.The problem we have in our life, we think it's something external thing. It's something, oh, because of that company, because of my friend, because of my parents, because of my wife, husband, now I'm suffering, I have this problem. And if you think that, then you will never be able to free oneself from suffering. Because if you think the causes and condition of your own suffering, pain, is external, some other thing, right?Then the other thing is immeasurable. There are so many. You cannot fix other thing. Maybe you can fix 10 things, but you cannot fix 100 things, right? So Shantideva said, no, this is not the causes of your problem. Causes of a problem is your own mind. So take care of your own mind. You don't need to fix everything external, because that's not the causes and condition of your suffering. For example, right?Do not attempt to cover the whole earth with leather. That's not possible. But cover your own feet. That's good enough. He said that. And that's why, you know, practice of taking care of our own mind, right, is the essential practice. Other practice we don't really need much.
那么 么为什么吉谦菩萨会如此说呢？其实就用一个例子来讲，例如如果我们要赤脚行走，我们就是赤脚走在大地上，其实我们知道就是地上地面上有可能会有一些尖锐的或者是一些会刺伤我们脚的东西。那么解决之道是什么？我们这样子去想想，我们有可能就是用一个皮革盖住整个这个大地吗？是不可能的。但是我们可以做的是什么呢？其实就是用皮革，就是古时候嘛，他们其实那个鞋子，我们其实只要用皮革盖住我们自己的脚，或者说现在我们就穿鞋子就够了，我们不需要去盖住整个大地。同样的就是如此，我们常常都会觉得我们的问题来自于哪里，都是外面哦，就是因为那个公司啊，我的另一半，我的老公啊很讨厌，或者是我的老婆他总是创造问题，或者是我这个朋友不对那个，我们觉得困难跟苦难是来自外在的。但是呢，如果我们这样子去想，其实我们永远没有办法找到解决之道，我们是没有办法自由的。因为真正的问题不在外面，其实是在我们的这颗心。同样的，我们是不可能用多大的多大的皮革去盖住整个大地，但是呢我们可以就盖住我们自己的脚就好了。也许外面我们可以修正，你最多让你去修正改正一些十个状况好了，你不可能去修正一百个，对吗？但是你只要照顾好这颗心，就如吉天菩萨所说的，其实最重要的就是要照顾好这颗心，我们其实就不需要去修正去改变外在任何的状况，因为外在的状况条件是无量无尽的，是我们没有办法掌控的。所以我们不用皮革盖住大地，我们只需要盖住自己的脚。同样的，当我们能够照顾好自己的心，这就是最重要，我们不需要太多其他的羞耻。
Yeah, and also Shantideva, he said, not only Shantideva, lots of other great masters, they said, right, when we have a headache, right, headache is a huge problem, right? Sometimes headache can be a huge problem, and it hurts it, and it, how to say, bugs us a lot, this headache. But Shantideva, he said that actually, you know, headache, the pain that we have in our head, is not the real problem. The real problem is, you know, real cause and cause of our pain, headache, is because we have a head. Understand? We have a head which allows the possibility of pain, headache, right? If we didn't have a head, we won't have any headache. If we didn't have any body, there won't be any pain, right? Because we have a body, that's why it allows the pain, isn't it? We have a head, that's why we have a headache, right? So Buddha and Bodhisattvas, all of those masters says, pain is not the real only cause and condition of the problem, but there is also a way to see. We have a headache because we have a head, first of all, right? We have our body has a problem, our body has a sickness because we have a body, right? Having a body is a problem, so it is not entirely other people's problem. The main causes and condition is us. Because we have a body, we have a pain. Because we have a head, we have a headache. There's one way to see.
那么，其实就如不止吉天菩萨如是说，其实很多其他伟大的佛教导师啊、上师们，他们都是这样子说的，也就是照顾好我们这颗心。其实，让我们看看另一个状况，头痛。头痛呢，这个英文字是 head ache， 就是头在痛。然后有时候这个头痛会带给我们很多的这种痛苦，如果你真的有头痛的这个问题。但是呢，你真的去看 OK， 这个头痛它的主因是什么，我们会觉得啊，就是因为这个痛嘛，就是这个头痛。但是其实你知道吗，就像这个组合字头痛，其实真正的问题不是痛，其实是因为我们有这个头。 你其实如果没有头，你就没有这个头痛，对吗？同样的，如果我们没有这个身体，我们就没有病痛的问题。所以说，当我们真的去看、去探究的时候，你就会发现，不是说那个痛是个问题，其实就是因为我们已经有这个身体，我们有这个头，我们有这个身体，所以我们会遭遇到这样的一个状况。同样的，痛苦其实不是来自于外在的，我们其实必须要看清楚这当中的组成。就是如果你没有身体，没有头，其实我们是不是就没有这些问题？但是呢，真正的问题其实并不是来自外在，不是来自他人。我们要看清楚，其实就是因为我们本身，我们就是有这样的一个肉体，所以我们会有这些痛苦。
Yes, and the reason why Shantideva he said those things, right? Is because when we are angry, right? We are so angry. Is because we think, right? We don't have the causes and conditions. We ourselves didn't create the problem. We think like that. We entirely blame other people, right? You are the reason why all those problems happen. You know, we blame other people entirely. Like I have like oneself nothing to do with it. That's the reason why we get so angry, you know, we rage so hard, right? It's because we think that it's all you, it's all them, it's not me at all, right? So that's why Shantideva said, it's not all them. Biggest part is us, because we have a body, because we have a head. That's why headache and body ache happens in our life, right? Now, these things are easy to understand, easy to listen, but it's not easy to accept.
为什么吉天菩萨如是说呢？就是我们可以看到，当我们生气、愤怒的时候，我们其实常常第一个举动，我们会去责怪外在的，我们会去责怪别人。我们很生气的时候，我们会觉得。就是因为你，或怎么说，就是因为那个人，或者是他们怎样怎样，然后我好生气，这跟我一点关系都没有。其实我们在愤怒的时候，我们想的都是外，我们觉得说自己是对的，没有问题的，问题都是出在别人的身上。然后呢，但是我们如果真的去探究，我们其实会知道不是这么简单的。就像我们有身体。我们有头，所以我们有头痛，有病痛，因为有这样的一个存在。同样的，就是因为我们有这个我，所以说其实我们会有这样的一个愤怒的状况。那这样的事情呢，其实去知道很容易，听起来也很容易，但真正的去接受、领受是很难的。
Yeah, and at that moment, right? The reason why we do is not easy for us to accept is.Because our mindset, you know, because if we have, so it is very important for us to change our mindset, you know, because I'm practicing Buddhism, right? That's why I'm not just, think like, oh, this is, because I have a head, that's why I have a headache.Not just like that. We have one muti, right? A purpose, right? What is the purpose? To get enlightenment, right? To get enlightenment, Shantideva say, practice of mind, right? Mind training practices is the most important thing. And that's how we train our mind, right? This is one way to see, really. In normal life, it doesn't make sense.If someone hit you on the head, you know, police will catch him, not you, right? Because he hit you on the head. But Buddha, Bodhisattva, they are saying, it's not entirely their problem, you know. I have also a problem because I have the biggest problem because I have a head, I have a body. That's why there's a headache. That's why there's a body ache, right? So they are just, how to say, tricking our mind to...control the anger. There is a way to see, you know, oneself. Because the way we see, the way we think matter the most all the time.
所以呢，为什么说这是没有办法，就不容易去接受的？也就是说，真正的你要知道，问题不是只是在外面，而是在跟我们自身是息息相关的。其实最重要的是，就是我们的这颗心，我们要能够去看到这当中的一个相依。当我们能够改变我们的心，其实我们就改变了我们的看法。佛教的修持，它其实真正在讲的，我们讲说 OK， 我们为什么要学佛，我们为什么要修行，其实最大的目的是什么？我们是不是要能够解脱证悟？同样的，当我们能够知道说 OK， 我们现在有这个头痛，我们有这个身体的病痛，其实就是因为我们本来就有这个我的存在，有这个身体。那么吉天菩萨他曾经他说过，我们真的要达到证悟，其实我们唯一要做的就是去修行，我们要修持我们的这颗心。修行其实就是要修行这颗心。如果说 OK， 你说外在的问题，譬如说现在如果真的有人来攻击你，然后他打你的头，那警察会抓的是不是就是这个人？因为是这个人出了问题。但是我们当我们真的去探究的时候，你就会发现痛苦不是这么简单的黑白分法的，其实就是因为我们自己本身，我们有这个肉体，我们有头，我们有身体，我们就有所有这些病痛。那么外在的状况让我们有愤怒，其实就是因为它触动了，它其实所触动的是我们的这一颗心。那外在的一切，其实我们如果能够把它看作，它其实最重要就是让我们学会如何掌控我们这一颗心。那么其实这就是最重要的一件事情。
Yes, and these things work really.This thing really work when there's a certain problem, right? Instead of thinking, you know, it's entirely them. If you think like, oh, of course, I also have some contribution to my own problem, right? If we are able to accept that, the anger, the emotion, we can control much better, right? For grown up,For us, right, these things very childish, you know, this doesn't really make sense. Oh, I have a head, that's why there's a headache. This doesn't make really sense much, but it doesn't mean that using this method, we can control our mind. It doesn't mean. We can control our mind. We can. Because our mind is like that. For example, I give you an example. You know, let's say we know, all of us know, you know, I think we don't have anyone like below 32. Maybe probably I'm the youngest one here. I'm 32 years old. And we know I'm getting old, right? Everybody getting old, not only me. So, and we know we have wrinkles all over our face and...We are not as young as we used to be. And when we take a picture, we don't use the phone camera. We use those what beautify camera, right? And we know, right? If we use the real camera, we don't look good enough. But we use that beautify camera, right? Which means that the picture which is gonna take is not.Exactly how we look, we know that, but we use that beautiful camera, and of course we will look beautiful, better, because that's the purpose of this whole app and camera, the phone, right? Then when we look a little bit better, and we are very happy. Does it really make sense? We know that we are not as pretty as we look in that camera, right? Because we use that beautiful camera, beautify camera, right? But we are happy. Oh, 很漂亮 oh, 很帅 It doesn't really make sense, but we are happy, see? That's how our mind works like, really. At those moments, if we really, when this problem happened in our life, right, instead of blaming them, other people entirely, if we think, because I have a head, that's why I have a headache. I have a body, that's why I have a body ache, body pain, right? If we accept that this problem we have in our life, I also contribute in this problem, right? So if we accept like that, that we can control our anger much better. We can control our obsession much better. Just like, you know, when we feel happy, when we use this beautify camera and see once, think, I'm beautiful, something like that.
那刚刚所讲的，也就是修心，这个绝对是有帮助的，真的。你可以说，从外在来讲，也许不是全然，但是你如果能够接受，当有问题发生，然后你能够接受说，哦，就像因为我有身体，我有病痛，有头有头痛，你能够接受说，哦，其实我大概也要负一部分的责任。我们其实就能够好好的掌控自己的愤怒，因为那个当下我们就会知道说，哦，不是全然都是外在的问题，这绝对是有道理的。然后当我们能够接受说 OK， 我其实也要负责任，这个时候呢，其实就不像有时候头痛我们会觉得哇完全没有办法控制，但是心是我们绝对可以学习去控制的。所以说人们其实他就在问大家说，在场应该有30岁以下的吗？当然我知道那个就是大部分的我们其实都已经30岁以上了，对不对？那人们其实就说他其实他自己32岁，那他应该算是挺年轻的。然后我们大家都知道，人们就说他自己越来越老，其实我们大家都在变老，然后变老其实我们就会长皱纹啊，脸上会有斑啊等等的。然后这时候就会有一个现象，就是每当我们照相的时候呢，我们不会去用那个手机真实的那个相机，我们会用那个美图的 app， 不管是修图美美啊还是什么，就是所有这些美图的那个 app， 然后我们就这样照相。然后其实也知道那个照起来跟我们现在真实看起来状况就是有一个间距，但是呢我们就会觉得哇照出来我们就很开心，因为我们就会觉得哇我看起来真好真漂亮，然后看那个照片自己也会开心。但其实你真的去看不太有道理的，因为那不是真实的状况。但是这就是我们的心，我们的心就是这样在作用着，我们的心就是这样在运作着。所以一样的，我们当外在有问题发生的时候，你如果能够首先你就知道啊，不是100%全然都是外面或别人的问题，因为其实有我这个存在，我其实可能也要负一些责任，就像头痛身体的病痛是一样的道理的。所以当我们能够这样子去探究的时候，我们其实就能够去接受 OK 有问题，我们其实就能够掌控我们的愤怒，我们其实就不会这么的执着。这其实就跟刚刚我们讲那个美图的那个概念是一样的。
Yes. So the practice of controlling our mind, or practice of taking care of our mind, right? Which we reference as a mind training, really. It's very important. Mind training is important for our general life. It's important if you are a business people. It's important if you are a teacher. It's important if you are a mother, right? So you guys must like try to learn about mind training, you know, try to learn as much as about how to control our mind, how we should think, you know, when we face a huge problem in our life. These things are the, how to say, the most valuable gift that can Buddhists can offer to you, and all of you must, you know, go for this, because we don't want to be honest, we don't want to get enlightened after 3,000 years, right? We don't want to be happy next year, right? We want to be happy right now. We want to be free of suffering right now, right? Our mentality is like, I need it as soon as possible kind of mentality, right? And if you really want that productivity, right, very quick productivity, then the quickest way to be happy, quickest way to free yourself from suffering, right? Quickest way to unload the pressure of suffering is mind training, really. It's not puja, it's not prayers. Of course, doing puja helps. Of course, prayers helps a lot. But if you want to be happy as soon as possible, the fastest path, fastest way is mind training. And instead of going for a huge puja, everything, really, always try to ask question or learn about mind training. Really, it's very fast.
所以只要我们能够去修持，学习如何去修心，掌控我们的心，其实呢，你可以说这个修心呢，它的利益真的是无量的，它可以说是最重要的。对我们一般的这种生活来讲，不管你是生意人士，不管你是一个老师，你是一个母亲，不管你是什么角色，你生活当中的角色扮演，你当你能够学习如何去修持我们这颗心，修心，我们怎么样掌控我们自己这颗心，其实呢，这个时候你就会发现你已经掌握了最重要的一件事情。其实就是当我们这样去思考，你最重要的一件事情，最真正可以说最珍贵的礼物，佛法可以给予我们的，其实就是修行。我们真正修持其实就是要去学习如何去修持掌控我们自己这颗心，这是我们大家都应该去学习的。因为讲实在话，说老实话，我们学佛，我们绝不要不会去想说我3000年以后才能证悟，然后或者你想说哦，我明年也许就可以快乐起来了吧，然后或者想说啊，也许在多久以后我可以得到解脱。其实我们的心都是有这种倾向的，我们希望一切事情越快越好，我们都要有效率生产率。所以说当你真的要这样子去看待的时候，你修持其实最快怎么样能够让我们的痛苦解除，怎么样能够让我们有自由，其实最快的方法就是修心。说实在话，不是祈祷，不是法会，是修心。当然祈祷跟法会是有帮助的，但是你真的最快的方式，其实你就是要去学习如何修持自己的这颗心，然后这是我们真正要去着重的重点，去学习，去问问题，去修持到底修心该怎么样去进行。
Yes, so mind training is very important, right? So me being as a monk from a Sakya tradition, right?The best mind training teaching that we as a Sakya can offer to you guys is mind training of parting from four attachment, mm-hmm. which is taught or given, the teaching which is given to Sachin Kunga Nyingbo by Manjushri himself.
那么呢修行教法是最重要的。人们现在说他来自，他是一个萨迦传承的出家众，然后以萨迦派的教法来讲呢，能够提供他可以给大家最好的一个修行教法，就是远离四种执着。那这个教法呢，是由文殊菩萨直接传给萨迦 ，sorry，the name of the master，
萨迦贡嘎宁波，
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 萨迦贡嘎宁波。萨迦贡嘎宁波他直接从文殊接到这个远离四种执着的教法，那这是最好的一个萨迦派的修行教法。
萨迦贡嘎宁波， I think he was probably like 12 years old, right? He was in retreat of a Manjushri retreat, and after like 6 months, I guess Manjushri he himself appeared, right, in his vision, right? Usually say the dream, but I would prefer to say visionRight, in his vision, Manjushri appeared, right? And Manjushri give him four line of teaching, just four line, one stanza, which is if you are attached to this life, you are not a Dharma practitioner, right? If you are attached to this life, you are not a dharma practitioner. Siddhi lashana chupamin. Khorwa lashana ngijungmin. If you are attached to this samsara, there's no renunciation mind. Right? And if you are very attached to your own self-interest, then you are not a bodhisattva. And if you have a wrong view, then you don't have a wisdom. So these four lines can accept the whole teaching of Buddha.
那么萨劝贡嘎宁婆他是大概十二岁的时候他在做文殊闭关修持，然后大概就是在四个月之后他有了一个镜像，直接文殊视线。那当然有人说是梦境，但人们现在还喜欢说其实就是在那个镜像当中就修持的一个就验证镜像出现，然后文殊直接告诉他这个教法。那其实他只有四句话，就是一个偈颂文四句话，但是呢这个偈颂呢它其实就包含了佛法全部的要义。那这四句话呢，第一句话就是执着此生非行者，你对这一生有任何执着你就不是一个佛法修行人。第二句话，执着轮回非出离，你对轮回当中你有任何执着你就没有出离心。第三句话，执着己利非菩萨，你对自身的利益你有任何的执着你就不是一位菩萨。然后第四句话，执着邪见非智慧，你只要对任何错误的见地有所执取那就没有智慧。
The fourth one.
Yeah. 第四句话还是 OK。那我现在就是念就是他有寄送的方式好吗？第一句就是执着此生非行者，修行人非行者。第二句话，执着轮回非出离，就没有出离心。第三句话，执着己利，自己的利益，执着己利非菩萨。然后第四句话，执着邪见非智慧。那这我现在这是我可以给他最好，当然就是外面会有翻译的更好的，之后再补给大家。
Yes, and there's also a teaching, right? There's also other four stanza. We say, lo chus dor chingilap, you know, may my mind proceed toward the dharma.
Yeah. 那当然也有另一个类似，就是一样是非常有力量，涵盖很多法教在内的这四句偈颂文，就是刚波巴四法。第一句就是愿心转向法。
And also may that the dharma that I practice, become the path. May the dharma that I practice right now, right, become the path.
然后第二句话就是愿心转法。第二句话就是愿法一直道而前进，就是愿我自己修持的这个佛法呢，能够在这个道上前进。
May that the path, right, clear the, errors. Understand?
Yeah, the confusion.
Yeah, you can say confusion, yeah.
Yeah. 然后第三句话就是愿这个法道能够澄清困惑。
And may all those illusionary vision, right, may appear as the wisdom.
然后第四句话就是愿能转惑为智，就是转换所有这些困惑这些虚幻为智慧。
Yes, so this Kunkin Koramba, right, he has this commentary about aparting from full attachment. And he liked to combine these two stanzas together, right? The stanza from the Manjushri and from Kampopa, he tried to combine them together and teach them.
Which master?
Kwaramba, Gungin Kwaramba.
Kwarampa. Kwarampa.
Yeah.
那么就是有这样的一位大师 ，Kwarampa 大师，他其实呢，他就是喜欢把萨迦这个远离四种执着，加上这冈波巴释法，刚刚那十句话，他把它融合，然后来给予教法。
Yes, so in his okay, let's just start, right? So we practice, right? We practice with Buddha Dharma, right? We need to check ourselves. Why do we do all those Buddhist practices, right? Is it for this life? Or is it for next life? We think like that, right? But many people, especially those beginners, they think, oh, Dharma is not for this life. Dharma is for next life. No, Dharma is not for life at all. Dharma is for enlightenment. You understand? People have this huge misunderstanding, you know, which is very common. So people, you know, like, oh, the reason why practice, we should never think about this life. You know, we always have to think about the next life. No, not even next life, not even life at all. The reason why we practice is for enlightenment, you know.
我们必须要去思考，为什么我们要学佛？我们修持佛法真正的理由跟原因到底是什么？那很多初学者呢，他就会觉得说，哦，我知道我学佛是为了我的来生，然后其实不管你学佛，你学佛修持佛法，你其实不是为了此生，绝对也不是为了来生。你学佛最重要的理由是为了要达到证悟，你甚至不要讲哪一生了，其实你就是要解脱轮回。所以说当你真正的知道说 OK， 你其实学佛最重要的它不是关于此生，它也不是关于来生，它跟你的哪一生都没有关系，它其实最重要的我们要修持佛法就是为了要达到证悟。
Yes, so if we are attached, right, if we are attached to this life, if we are attached to any life, we are not really practicing Dharma. So our mind can never proceed towards, you know, the Dharma. That's what it meant, right? The two stanzas. First one, if we have attachment to our life, we are not a Dharma practitioner, right? So if we are attached to this life, if we are attached to next life, now Gampopa's first stanza, right? Triple Gem bless my mind to proceed toward the Dharma. This will never happen. Understand? So as soon as our practices, right, we do daily, is for enlightenment, not for this life, not for life at all, then our mind, right, can proceed toward the Dharma, then it's, which means that we are doing real Dharma. Understand? So we are really not, we, to be honest, right, if we are really serious Dharma practitioner, we don't give a crap about life at all. To be very serious, to be very honest. We don't care about life at all. That's the real purpose.
所以当我们真正这样去了知的时候呢，你就会知道，我们如果对此生或对来生，或者你说不管哪一生有任何执着，这就不是佛法。你只要有这样的执着，你就没有办法转心向法。所以说就是那第一句话，执着此生非行者。然后你只要对这个生活，你只要对这个生活这个生命你有任何的执着，你其实就没有办法真正好好的去依佛法而修持，你更不要讲能够让你的修持在道上能够前进。就像冈波巴释法第一句，请加持我的心，让我的心，让心转向法。我们首先必须要去知道，我们其实不能执着此生，也不要讲执着来生，有执着就不是佛法。所以说能够真正这样去了解，你其实真正身为一个修行人啊，你其实对生活你是很自在的， 你不会在乎很多事情。有些人他其实真的不在乎说哦生活怎么样，就是修行人来讲，他们其实是非常自在的。
Yeah, and the second stanza, right? If you are attached to samsara, you do not have a renunciation mind, right? So renunciation mind is very important, really. I mean, if you are a serious Buddhist practitioner, right? If you are just attending teaching, listening to, advice of reading books, of, you know, Buddhist, just for, as a hobby, it's okay. Just have a fun, that's good. That's the most important thing, right? But if you are a real Buddhist practitioner, really, one of the most important thing is to have renunciation mind. Renunciation, right? We have to renounce everything. So, Manjushri, he said, if you are attached to samsara, you do not have a renunciation mind of renunciation. Then, when you don't have a renunciation mind, what happens is that whatever you think you are doing right now, let's say you may think that I'm practicing dharma, but that's the dharma, right, will never become a path. Understand? Right? So if you are attached to samsara, you do not have a mind of renunciation. And when you do not have a mind of renunciation, you think, oh, gongyang, offering, generosity, all those practices, you think it is a dharma, right? But that dharma will never become a path, which means that the dharma will not be able to clarify all those confusion, you can say, or errors, you know. Misunderstanding.
那么在我们来看第二句话，也就是文殊菩萨他所说的执着轮回非出离。你只要在对这个轮回，对这个世界，你其实有任何的执着，你就缺少了出离心，你就没有出离心。出离心其实非常重要的，对一个真正严肃的修行人来讲，如果你今天来听闻佛法，你今天去研读学佛，你其实讲哦，那就是我的一个兴趣，然后我的一个嗜好，然后我这些这样听听，我听快乐的哦，那当然这就是最重要的，这样就很好了。但是如果你是一个认真的佛法修行者，你其实就必须要知道出离心是最重要的。出离心可以说是一切的基础。为什么说执着轮回非出离？因为其实出离心就是我们必须要出离一切所有的世间，甚至我们刚刚讲的此生来生，我们都必须要有这样的一个，就是觉得说我们不要去执着任何一个东西，然后我们要有这个出离，就是你知道吗，就是要生出这种厌离，你对这些你其实很厌倦的。你如果没有这样的出离心，其实任何你做的，你可以严格上来讲它就不是佛法修持，那你更不要讲你根本就没有办法转你的修持为道，转法为道，你也没有办法在道上你能够前进。一般我们常常会觉得说哦，我就是这样做供养啊，然后所有这一切法会啊，这些就是佛法。不是的，其实真正最重要的佛法之道最基础的，首先就是这个出离心。
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying, right? At the first session, right, few days ago, I told, right, many of us think we are practicing Buddha Dharma.But we are not actually practicing Buddha Dharma. We are just, practicing the idea of practicing Buddha Dharma. Because to be honest, right? To be honest, don't we love this life? I love this life very much, right? I love this life very much. I love this world very much. I want to come back again, really. And there's so many things in this samsara, right, that I cherish, I really am attached to. So when you have this kind of problem, this thing going on in your mind, right, you may think, I'm practicing Buddha Dharma, right, but actually I'm not. I'm just practicing the idea of practicing Buddha Dharma. And this happens a lot. Right now, it's not really bad for me because now I realize that, oh, I'm not really actually practicing Buddha Dharma, but more likely, I'm practicing the idea of Buddha Dharma. Now I realize, which means it's already an improvement, isn't it? So that's why it is very important to understand.
那人们现在上周的时候呢，他其实就有谈到，我们很多人都觉得自己在学佛，自己在修持佛法，但其实不是真的那么一回事。我们所修持的，其实就只是我们对佛法的一些概念。讲实在话，那人们现在以他自己为例子，我们大家真正去想想，难道我们对此生没有任何的贪爱吗？我们对此生，我们真的什么都觉得说都不重要，我们没有爱任何一个东西吗？然后人们就说，他其实看他自己，他其实对此生，他说他对他自己这一生他是非常爱的，然后他其实对这个世界他也挺爱的，他都希望自己以后未来能够再回来这个世间，然后甚至他说他去看轮回当中很多的事物，他其实是有珍惜，他有珍爱一些东西，而且他挺执着的。那其实就是他很真实的去看说 OK， 他真正在做的其实是在修持一些佛法的概念而已，这其实真的不是真正的在修持佛法。但是他说还好，就是他自己没有错的离谱，因为他觉知到哦，他有这样的一个状况，然后其实他有所有这些执着跟贪爱，所以说呢，他说很诚实的说，其实他只是在修持佛法的一些概念，所以我们也必须要这样子去反观自照。
Yes, and the third stanza, right? If you are attached to your own self-interest, you don't have a mind of bodhicitta. You know, you don't have bodhicitta mind. And when we don't have a bodhicitta mind, you know, the dharma that becomes a path, right? Dharma that becomes a path.That path, you know, will not be able, if you don't have a bodhicitta mind, you know, that path will never clarify the errors, the confusion on our way to enlightenment. That's what it happened.
那么在我们看第三句话，刚刚是说执着己力非菩萨，但是就是也有执着己力讲非菩提。什么是菩萨？其实就是菩提心，我们其实就是有发出一个菩提心。如果我们对自身的利益，就是自己的好处，我们有任何的执着，其实我们就没有菩提心。那你如果没有这个菩提心，你就不要去想说你的法能够依道前进，你的这个道，佛法之道能够澄清净化你自身的困惑跟无明，更不要去想说你最后能够转这个困惑为智慧。
Yes, and the last stanza, right? If there's a grasping, we can say, if there's a grasping, there's no view, right? Right? You can say.
Wrong view before.
Yeah.
If we grasp attached to the wrong view, it's not wisdom.
First, I translated like this, right?
Yes.
Same. Okay. Yeah, if you have a wrong view, we don't have a wisdom, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when we don't have a wisdom, right, the fourth stanza of Kampopa, you know, that all the illusionary vision cannot appear as a wisdom. Understand? This doesn't make sense right now, but we are about to talk about wisdom very soon, right?So these things happen.
那么第四句话呢，就刚刚讲的执着邪见非智慧，但是其实它有另一个说法，就是若有执着非智慧，就你只要有任何执着，其实你就没有智慧的存在。那任何执着，这个时候其实可以讲说，你其实有任何执着，它就是一种错误的一种见地，那你其实就没有智慧。你更不要去想说哦，你能够最后得到解脱跟证悟，因为当你有任何的执着，你其实就没有办法让这个法道能够去澄清净化你的 迷惑跟无明，你更不要去想说你能够转惑，转这个困惑为智慧，你也不要去想说之后能够证悟什么。那这个是之后仁波切会更深入去谈到的。那刚刚讲的这一切其实都是非常重要的。
Yeah, so from this four line, right, we can understand the how severe, how serious this Buddha Dharma is, you know, right? No attachment to this life.
Is it possible?
Very difficult, right? No attachment to this samsara, to this world at least. Do you think it is possible? Very difficult.No attachment for all our self-interest. Whatever we do it for other people, for whole sentient beings. Is it possible? Very difficult, right? So from this, right, from this like teaching, we can understand how serious when we say, oh, I'm practicing Buddha Dharma, right? This has to be the qualities.These qualities are required for us to be the Buddha, Buddhist practitioner. Do we have that? We don't. I don't have. I don't know about you guys, but I don't have that quality. I don't have that capability to give up my own self-interest. I don't have capability to give up my own life. I don't have capability to have no attached to my own, to this world. Right?So do we think, right, Buddha Dharma is about our life, to make our life happy, to make our life easy, the real purpose? Do we think? No at all. See, Manjushri say, I don't care about your life, you know, don't get attached to your life, right? Manjushri say, have no self-interest, right?We are not actually caring about life. What we are caring about is to free ourselves from this suffering, right? And how we should free oneself. That's only two things that Manjushri was very concerned about it. And that's how our Buddha Dharma practice has to be like.
那由刚刚这个就是这四句话，远离四种执着，刚不发四法。我们其实真的可以看到，佛法它其实是非常严肃，可以说它是其实是很严格的。你真的要讲佛法，你要说对此生无执着，你对轮回、对这个世界，你都没有任何的贪恋，然后同样的，你对自己的任何利益，你完全不在意，你不执着。你所做的一切都是为了他人，为了一切众生的利益。你真的去思考，你会发现其实这是相当困难的。然后真的，我们真的是认真严肃的在修持佛法吗？我们有刚刚所讲的所有这些特质、这些条件吗？那仁波切他说他自己很诚实跟大家分享，他看他自己，他都说他其实没有。他真的不在乎他自己的利益吗？他不是的。他对自己的这一生他完全不在意吗？可以完全舍弃吗？他也没有。然后他对这个世间他绝对也有一些执着的。所以当我们真正去思考，他说他不知道大家什么状况，但我们真的去思考佛法它其实真的不是要让我们这一生的生活能够更快乐更简单，绝对不是这么一回事。就文殊菩萨他所言的，他刚刚文殊菩萨他所讲的，他其实一点都不在乎你这一生状况是什么。他其实最重要的就是说，你不要在乎己利，然后你不要有任何执着。他其实最在意的就是如何能够让我们离苦，能够把苦因移除，然后我们从苦难中解脱，然后我们能够真正解脱证悟。这其实是佛法真正在修持的状况。
Yeah.But don't be worried, right? Oh, now Buddhism doesn't really care about life much. So if I practice Buddhism, I think I have to give up all my, samsaric life, worldly life. But it's not like that, right? if we have these qualities, right, no attachment toward our life, no attachment toward the samsara, no attachment toward our self-interest, those happiness, right, those, how to say, temporary happiness, is not like, oh, a Buddhist practice is against this outcome. It's not against, really. All of those things happen, but these are the not the, it will happen to you as a byproduct. Understand? On the way to reach enlightenment, right, you will be happy. You know, if you change the way of your thinking, right, those stress, those problems will be much less strong. Understand? So these are just a byproduct. But don't think, right, don't think like that. Oh, now it's not about our life, so Buddhism is not really useful at all. No. If you have these qualities that Manjushri asked Sajjan Kunga Nyingpo to have, right, then all those happiness will happen to you as a byproduct. Understand? It's not the real product that we long for. So this is something you must understand. Otherwise, it sounds very, how to say, discouraging.
那么可以说呢，而且现在要强调说，大家请也不要去想说，哦，原来佛教是这么的严肃。如刚刚所说的，如果我真的修持佛法，我好像必须要放弃一切，然后必须要出离，就放弃所有整个轮回，我要放弃这个世间。其实不是这样的，应该说，我们要能够真正去非常诚实的看，我们能不能就是对此生、对轮回以及对自己的利益，我们能够不去执取。然后，当我们真正能够做到这个样子的时候，其实这一生，这短暂的一生，所有的一切，它其实会很自然而然的，该发生的会发生。佛法绝对不是再去就是违背此生，或者说绝对要放弃所有的一切世间啊、生命啊、轮回，不是的，而是说，如果我们能够做到一个修持佛法这样的一个态度，也就刚刚讲的那三个执着，其实所有这一生该发生的，它会就有点像是个红利点数，它很自然而然就会发生，它其实就会很顺利的就会发生。但是呢，它其实很重要的，当我们能够有这样的出离的时候呢，我们很自然而然的，我们的问题还有我们生活的压力，它其实都会降低。请不要想说，哦，佛法对这个人生、对这个生命、生活好像一点用处都没有，请不要想，而是文殊菩萨他其实只是在教我们，如果我们能够对此生轮回几历，我们能够出离的话，那么很自然而然的，我们这一生也会很自然而然的被照料好，很自然而然，这些该发生的，它会就像红利点数一样的，你买一送一，你把佛法修持好，你其实你的生活上面你就不会有太大的问题。这些几历轮回以及这些所有的这些生命，一切你觉得好的快乐，这不应该是我们去渴求去执着的，这是我们必须要很清楚的一个概念，不然我们会觉得哇，佛法有点让人沮丧。
Yes. So but so now this Buddhist so far Buddhist practitioner, the practice sounds very how to say, pessimistic. Yeah, it sounds very pessimistic, you know, pessimistic, and but it is not pessimistic, and it is also not, Buddhism is also not optimistic, right? We are not only, how to say, paying attention to those bad stuff, and we are not only paying attention to those good stuff only, right? But Buddhism is more like a realistic. We are not optimistic, we are not pessimistic, but we are more realistic. It means that we are not pretending that everything is good. Understand? We are not pretending that everything around us is good. We are not pretending everything with me, with oneself, or with other is good. Right? We are how to say, trying to figure out the reality. That's why Buddhism is more like a realistic. It's not pessimistic or nor the optimistic.
那么到现在来讲呢，其实就是讲到现在，大家可能会觉得说，嗯，这个佛法严肃上来讲，其实听起来有一点消极跟悲观。其实真的不是这样，佛法它其实不是消极的，但是它也绝对不是悲观，但是也必须要讲佛法不是乐观的。它佛法教我们的不是说叫我们只去注意这些坏消息、不好的事情，但是佛法它也不是教我们就是只注意这些好事。其实我们要讲的是，佛法它是非常实在的，它是非常实际的，可以说它有点像类似这种实际主义。因为所有的这一切，就佛法它不是说哦，你不要，它其实最重要的一个讯息就是你不要去假装一切都很好。我们不要假装说其实一切都很好，我自己也很 OK， 然后他人也很 OK， 其实一切都非常的美好，不是的。但是呢，佛法它其实只是在教导我们，我们必须要搞清楚状况，我们其实真的要去看清楚一切。
Yeah, so practicing Buddhism, right, is more like we are looking forward to the good ending. Right now, not very good ending. Right now is very severe, right? Sounds very serious.But at the end, right, the ending would be very nice, which is enlightenment.
所以呢，佛法不是说到目前为止，其实听起来大家觉得我真的太严肃了，好像你就是不是在找一个有这样一个圆满的结局。那当然，其实线下大家去看，你会觉得哇很严肃，然后好像没什么好事。但是我可以仁波切说，他要告诉大家的是。最终就是佛法之道，最终那个结局绝对是好的，圆满的结局就是证悟解脱。
Yeah, so now we must talk about wisdom now, right? Most of the people they think wisdom is like, oh, 他很有智慧 ，right? 因为他学习了十一年 ，right? They study for 13 years, 20 years. But that's not wisdom, really. That's just information. That's just a knowledge. You can say it's just a knowledge that you gain from reading books, but that's not the wisdom. It's very important, right? Information, knowledge, wisdom is a very different thing, right? So don't think you just have information, it's mean that you have wisdom. No. Google have the most...information in the whole world, but Google is not a wisdom or anything, right? Google doesn't have a wisdom. So do not confuse a word wisdom as knowledge or as information, really, because people overuse this word wisdom all the time.
那么接下来我们要谈的就是智慧。请大家不要想说哦，一个这个学佛十年，就仁波切刚刚讲哦，他很有智慧，他已经学习了十年、十一年，然后甚至20年，他其实呢就是应该是一个很有智慧的人。这真的不是理由。有时候其实他所学的这样的一个学佛的人，他其实所学的可能就只是知识而已。我们必须要把知识。就是智慧上学习，就是你的智，你能够去分辨，然后你能够学习到的，然后变成你的自己的一份知识，还有智慧。我们要把这三个搞清楚。你如果说真的要有知识，你其实真的知识还有消息最多满满满的，其实就是 Google， 对吗？你任何你去 Google， 你就得到答案。但是 Google 它绝对不代表智慧。然后这是我们要很清楚的，我们不要，很多人他其实都会把知识就常我们讲情报啊、消息啊、新闻，知识还有我们学习到的一个知识还有智慧，很多人其实搞不清楚这三种的。
And how to say I give you example like you can read a book, right? Or, how to say, that cake that cake 蛋糕 oh, very nice, very sweet, very healthy, that's it. And you don't go to, go to that restaurant or place to eat that cake, right? But instead you read a lot of book about that cake. Now you know this cake sweet, how they make, what are the ingredients, all those information you have. But you never eat that cake, right? So this is like, this is the information that you gain from a book, reading books, right, about that cake. Do you think this is wisdom? No, right? Wisdom is now when you read, because of you read those books, right? Now you have so many ideas. Oh, what is actually? You think that you know, but you actually don't know. You just have the information. Now there's a lot of ideas. Oh, sweet might taste like this. Sweet might taste like this. There's so many, fantasy, wrong ideas in our mind, right? So those, the information you gather from those books will never expel, eliminate those ideas because you don't have the wisdom, right? So as soon as you go to that restaurant and eat that cake and you taste that cake using your tongue, your mouth, right? From that moment, you won't have any fantasy or wrong ideas about that cake's taste. Understand? From that very moment, you think, or you will know, oh, this is how the cake tastes like. This is how the sweetness tastes like, right? So that what is wisdom? Wisdom is something which eliminates, expel all the wrong views, misunderstanding, misconception. That's the wisdom. So usually we in Tibetan we say, we say, right, if you never taste the sweetness, the sourness, right, if you have never tasted sour, all the sweet is tasteless. Understand? So wisdom is something, you know, that expel the wrong views, expel all those misconceptions, expel those fantasies.
Sour.
Yeah.
The Tibetan saying,
yeah.
Sour.
Okay. If you never taste a sour, right, you will never understand the taste of sweetness.
那其实这就好比你听到哦，有一个蛋糕非常的有名，非常的闻名，然后你去读关于这个蛋糕的书啊，然后书中在描述哦，这蛋糕是怎么样制作，然后它有多好，然后它这个甜度尝起来是怎么样的一个感觉，然后它其实也非常的健康，然后你就是去读，但你从来没有去真的去餐厅去点这个蛋糕也吃那个蛋糕，但你就是知道很多关于这个蛋糕的讯息，但是你却从来没有真正去尝试到这个蛋糕。那其实这就有点像知识，你知道所有关于这蛋糕的一切，那这个知识它其实就不是智慧，你其实就是知道，但是你还不是真正的知道。所以说呢，你只知道说哦，这个蛋糕尝起来那个甜的感觉是像这个样子，然后刚刚好，然后什么什么，但是呢它你自己还没有真正品尝到。所以说知识它其实是没有办法去移除，它其实就是一个概念而已，只有智慧它能够真的去解除所有的这种未知跟困惑。然后终于你去了这个餐厅，你吃到了这个蛋糕，然后你终于知道哦，这个蛋糕尝起来它到底是什么味道，然后感觉是很健康的，然后你终于再也没有任何幻想，你非常清楚的知道这个蛋糕是怎么一回事，那你之前所有那些幻想啊，所有那些未知，这个时候就被移除掉了。所以说这就是智慧，它能够移除你所有的迷惑，你这种见解上的这种不明，就是不明确，还有你这种错误的了解，它是能够把它移除的。所以说西藏其实就有一句谚语，它讲说如果你没有尝过酸的滋味，你其实就不是真正能了解甜的滋味是什么， 其实就有点类似这样的意思。
Yeah, so in Mahayana sense, right, wisdom is, the meaning of wisdom is seeing the true nature of reality, which exactly means like seeing things as they are, you know, not how they appear to us. That's the meaning of wisdom.
那么在大乘教法里面是这样定义智慧的。智慧是什么意思呢？智慧其实你就是真实的去看到一切事物本然的状况，也就是实相。你看到一切事物本然如是的一个状况，而不是它所显现的那个表象。
For you guys to understand it, right? To understand this wisdom, right? Is not the most difficult one, really. It's quite easy to understand this wisdom part of Buddhism. It is not as hard to understand the mind of Bodhicitta, really. To understand the mind of Bodhicitta is the, I think for me, from my own experience, is the hardest one. For all the sentient beings, may I attain enlightenment. I cannot accept that. It's very difficult, really, to be honest. But to understand the emptiness is quite easy. So you may think, you know, Bodhicitta is quite simple, but emptiness is quite difficult to know. Trust me on this. Bodhicitta, training of understanding the mind of Bodhicitta is way more difficult than understanding the emptiness, you know, the wisdom of understanding the emptiness.
那么其实佛法的智慧它并不是那么难去理解的，其实是可以去研读去学习的。佛法的智慧其实它是能够，就是当我们去学习以后，我们是能够去了解的。但是其实更难的，最难的其实是菩提心。菩提心就对仁波切来讲，他觉得他对他自己来讲最难的，他觉得其实就是菩提心。菩提心为利众生愿成佛，他其实是没有办法接受了。他说这真的太难了，他说很多人都会觉得说空性很难，但他说请大家相信他，你真的去了解空性是什么，去知道空性是什么，其实是容易的。但是你真的要完全去了解菩提心修心是什么，那其实那是很困难的。
Yes.And now when we talk about emptiness, right, this word itself is very challenging, right? Emptiness means like on nothing, zero, right? But it doesn't mean, emptiness means negation of existence. Because when we think about, right, emptiness, you don't think about any other thing. Right? Whenever you, because...you think of one word, you know, in this Prajnaparamita, he said, form is emptiness, right? Then emptiness is form. Understand? So pay more attention to the next, the word, right? Form is emptiness. And the next one is emptiness is form. Right?So the next word is way more important than the first one, which means that Buddha is not saying there's no table. Buddha is saying there is table, right? Buddha is saying there's a man, there's a woman. Buddha never said no. If he said there's a, how to say, no table, then he won't be very famous.Right, really, there is a table. But what Buddha really meant, right? Table is there, right? It's not because it is there. We have our own karmic causes and condition to see the table. That's why table appeared to us. Not because table is there. Understand?
那么空性一讲到空性呢， 它其实是一个非常具挑战的字眼。你可以说呢，一讲到空性，你就会想啊，否定一切的存在，空空，一切都是空。但是呢，空性其实绝对不是去想说哦，所有一切都是空的。就如波尔波罗蜜多所说的，色即是空，空即是色。那其实这句话这样的一个寄送，它其实第二句话是更重要最重要的。人们现在说佛陀他绝对不是在讲说哦，没有桌子也没有一切。其实佛陀他说是的，桌子是存在的，人男女也是存在的。如果佛陀他只讲了说，就是第一句色即是空，讲说哦没有桌子的存在，那么也许佛陀就不会像现在这样是这么的成功有名。他其实要讲的是说 OK， 第二句话色即是空，他讲桌子是存在的，但是桌子的存在其实就是因为我们有这样的一份业力因缘和合，桌子显现在我们面前。
Yes. Now as I say, right, because we have our own karmic causes and condition to see table, right? Now this is very important because Vasubandhu, right? Is it Vasubandhu? Vasubandhu.
Abhidhammakosha?
Yeah. Vasubandhu, right? He said, all this creation, right? All this creation is not created by a god. All this creation is created by our own karma. Understand? Our own karma. And because we have a karma to see you, because I have a karma to see you guys, then I see you guys. Understand? And so let's say, if I don't have a karma to see you guys, even though I'm right now here, I won't see you guys. Understand? So what it really means is that you guys are not actually there. Right? That's what it means. You guys are not actually there. But I have my karma, karmic causes and condition to see you there. That's why you are there. Because my karmic causes and condition allows you to be there. Now if you have a karmic causes condition to see me, then you will see me. If you don't have causes and condition to see me here, even though you are right here, you won't see me. You understand? So that's what it meant. So it means that it is not there. It's always inside you. The karmic causes and condition. Because Vasubandhu said, right? Right? He said, because of karmic causes and condition, all those creation happened.
其实就是因为刚刚所讲的，因为有业力因缘的和合，我们看到了桌子，就如世亲菩萨所说的，一切由业力显现，所有一切的显现不是由一个造物主一个上帝所创造的，其实是因为我们自身的业力业缘。所以人们切说他其实就是因为有这样的业缘，他在这边见到了大家。如果他没有这样的业缘，他即使人在这边，他也看不到大家的存在的。那一样的，你可以说我们大家在，但是我们也不在。然后如果没有这样的业缘，我们如果没有业缘，我们其实也见不到仁波切。即使仁波切他现在在这边，我们没有这样的一个业力因缘和合，我们是看不到他的存在的。所以因为业力，因为业缘，你存在，他存在，然后我们能够在这边，然后仁波切看得到大家，我们大家看得到仁波切，其实这就是业力因缘的运作。所以这就是世亲菩萨所说的，一切由业所创。
Yeah, so that's why when you have a very pure karma, right, causes and condition, karmic causes and condition, all you see is Buddha and Bodhisattvas. Understand? That's why we say, you know, if you have connection,karmic connection, then you can see Buddha and Bodhisattvas. Yeah? So, if you don't have a karmic connection, you will never see Buddha. You will never see Bodhisattvas. Right? In Taiwan,
there's many
who regularly meet Buddha and Bodhisattvas.
I trust, really, because they might have that karmic connection, right? That's why, how to say, 跟菩萨讲话，对不对？
会，我也相信。I trust, right? I trust,
because, not because I cannot see Buddha and Bodhisattva doesn't mean that you also cannot see, right? If you have a karmic connection, karmic causes and condition, you can definitely see, definitely talk.And have coffee with Buddha and Bodhisattvas. Really, it's possible. Really, because this is not something I made up. Vasubandhu, right? He himself said, all this creation is created by our own karma and karmic conditions, right? Causes and condition. And Buddha is also result of our own karmic causes and condition. So if you have that connection, you can definitely see, you know, see, meet, have lunch, dinner.Anything is possible.
所以，当业力是清净的，如果有这样子清净的业力，你其实就能够亲眼见到一切诸佛菩萨身中。然后，当你有这样的一份业缘，就是你的业力是清净的，你就是亲见一切身中。你甚至呢？可以说其实人们就有注意到台湾有很多这样的人，他其实是可以，就是说可以直接亲眼见到佛菩萨，然后他也可以跟菩萨沟通，直接可以沟通的。那人们就说他相信这是可以存在的，因为只要你有业缘，然后你其实有一定的这样的因缘，你其实真的你就是可以亲眼的见到佛菩萨，然后你可以跟他对话，你甚至可以跟他喝咖啡。因为这人们就说这不是他说的，这是世亲菩萨所说的，一切是由业力因缘所创造而显现的。所以说当你有这样的业缘，我们其实就是因为有这样的业缘，我们能够有佛法，然后是遇到这个佛执事。所以说一样的，当你能够有这样的业缘的时候呢，你其实没有问题，就是可以跟圣众直接对话啊，吃午餐晚餐都没有问题。
Yeah, and this
now one important point is that Vasubandhu, right, he talk about karma and he talk about two different kind of karma. One is individual karma and one is collective karma, right? So individual karma isWhat you see, right? Karma means what make things happen. That's karma, right? And about how we create the karma, we talk about it in the next session, right? Next session. So karma means, right, what make things happen in our life. Understand? That's the meaning of karma. And...There's a two kind of karma. One is individual karma, your own karma, and one is collective karma, our collective karma, right? So, all of us, right, have a karma to see this table. That's why we see a table. All of us can see this table, right? That's because we have, all of us has the same...karma, you know, kind of same collective karma to see this table. That's why we see this table. So now, if you ask Buddha and Bodhisattvas that, are we looking at the same table? Right? And Buddha would say, no. The table you see is creation of your own karma. Understand? The table she see,is not exactly the same table that you are looking. It looks same because we have collective karma, right? But the table that you see, the table that she see, is not the same table. It's a very different table. Because this, the reason why this table appear, right, exists, is because of our own karmic causes and condition, right? So you have your own karmic condition to see this table. She has...her own karmic causes and conditions to see this table, right? So when two things, when things are appear out of different causes and condition, that thing can never be a same thing. Understand.
那么释迦牟尼菩萨所讲的业，他也把它分成两大类，一个是有情众生自己的业力，另一个就是有情众生所有一起的，我们讲共业。那么所以你所看到的其实是你自己的业力，你自己的一个业缘，你见到了那样的一个现象。那么其实因为我们如果要讲说 OK， 那业力是如何创造的，人们接下来下堂课会为大家讲这个内容。那么呢，业力其实就是所有一切发生在我们生命当中生活当中的都是由业所主宰的。那你有你自己的业力，他有他自己的业力，但是同样的我们所有一起也有一个共业。其实现在我们大家聚在这边，我们其实就是有这样的一份共业，所以可以看到人们现在他讲那个桌子，我们是可以看到这个桌子的，他也可以看到这个桌子，其实就代表说我们大家有这样的一份共业，我们见到了这个桌子。但是如果你再去说我们见到的这个桌子跟佛菩萨他看到的个桌子是一样的吗，那答案绝对会是不一样。为什么？因为你所看到的是有你自己的业缘因缘你看到，他所看到是他自己的业力因缘所看到，但是因为有共业，你会觉得哦，这个桌子讲起来大致上是一样，就是这张桌子。但是有两个人不同自己的业力因缘，他们所看到的那个桌子，两个人绝对是你可以说是不一样的一个现象。我们存在因为我们自己的一个业力因缘，然后因为我们的业力因缘我们看到了这样的一个现象，但是在这个同时我所看到的现象跟旁边的所看到的那个现象其实就已经是不一样，因为两个人的业力因缘是不一样的。
Yes. So for example, everybody know, you know, what is a projector, right? Projector is something like that.You know, when we project, right, when we use the projector machine, right, projector machine itself is like a karma, you know, what it project, right, because, but so when we project, right, you see a movie, and all those movie character in movie looks very real, right, when the actor, actress died in ocean,we cry, right? When the hero win, we be happy, all those things, right? These things looks very real to us. But in reality, if someone asks you, hey, mother, is that a real person? You would say, no, it's just a movie, right? So it's something like that, you know, because we have a karma and we have a mind and it project. Because of our own mind, karma, right? Our mind project different stuff.And we see. And your karma and your mind will project different stuff and you will see. But you think, oh no, we are seeing, looking at the same table. But no, we are not looking at the same table. We are looking at the table that looks alike. Understand? So what it really means that table is not there because it has its own intrinsic nature. Right? Intrinsic nature.Table is there because we, our own karma, allows that table to be there. Understand? Because you see, you know, you say, oh, this is real. And you ask, really? Then you will ask other people, can you see this? Is this real or not? You ask, yeah, I can see, I can see, I can see. Oh, that's real, right? That's how we prove it's real in our normal life. But in our Buddhism, our science, it say that...The reason why you see is your own karma, causes and condition, nothing else. And I will give you an example, very famous example in Madhyamika Avatara.
We all know what the projector is. It's the projector, you know, it can project, and then on the screen. And then we can see a lot of images. 电影就是这个样子，你知道吗？就是那个投射出来的。 那其实这个投影机就有点类似我们讲的业力，它其实就有点类似相似的一个作用，就是这个因为这个业，然后不断的所有的显象发生，然后我们看到了一切，然后我们会觉得哦，这就是真实的情况。有时候其实我们看电影，我们也会入戏，对吗？我们看到那个主角哦，他在海洋当中溺死了，我们会难过。哎，我们看到另一部那个主角赢了，我们会开心。我们其实就会随着那个显象有这样的一个起伏。但是呢，如果一个孩子问妈妈说：“哦，刚刚那个这样子发生是真的吗？”那母亲就会告诉那个孩子：“孩子，当然不是真的，那只是一部电影而已。”那其实这就有点类似，这个投像机就其实我们讲的业力，其实就是这个心。因为业力，我们一直看到所有各式各样的这些现象，但是我们现在大家就会觉得说，我们好像都在看同一张桌子，对吗？但是其实不是的，我们其实不是真正的在看同一张桌子。大家会觉得说，哦，我们现在你看到这个桌子，他看到这个桌子，这个桌子真的是在这边吗？不是的。为什么？因为其实这个桌子不是本然就存在的，这个桌子它没有真正一个实质的自信存在在那边，它其实会在这边显现。我们可以看得到，其实都是因为我们的业，因为因缘的合。你如果我们大家常会要证明说，哦，那个是不是真实存在？你看到了吗？你看到了吗？我看到了吗？然后用一个很科学的方式，对啊，大家都看到，那它一定是真实存在的。但是你知道吗？它不是真实存在。这个桌子我们大家能够看得到，其实是因为所有的业力，因为我们的业缘，我们看到了这个桌子。那人们现在接下来要给大家一个中观非常有名的一个例子来讲解。
Yeah, in Chandrakirti, right? Chandrakirti, he say in Madhyamika Avatara, say, human, right? Human have their own karmic causes and condition, right? And God has its own causes and condition. And hunger ghost have their own causes and condition, you know, karmic causes and condition. So when they look at the a place where the water falls, you know, water falls, because human, we have our own causes and condition to see a water, that's why we see a water there. But if a God, right, look at that spot where humans see a water, but God will see a nectar, understand? Mm-hmm. And when those hunger ghosts look at that very spot where God sees a nectar, hunger ghosts, they see a blood and pus, right? There's no water for them because they don't have a causes and condition. They don't have the karmic causes and condition to see a water there. That's why they don't see a water. They see a pus and blood. God sees nectar. Human sees water. So what it exactly means is that there is no any water there. There is no blood. There is no nectar. It's empty, right? There's nothing, but we see there water because we have our own karmic causes and condition to see our water, right? So everything is same like that. Right now we look at a building because we have causes and condition to see a building. But if there's other people who don't have a causes and condition, you know, karmic causes condition to see a building, they will not see a building there. But it looks very real to us, right? It looks very real. That's our weakness. So that's what it means, you know. So if we say water is real, right, then it doesn't matter who look at that thing. There has to be water because it's real, right? Understand? So that's why we need to clear all those karmic causes and condition to have a pure perception.
那么在就是中观这个很有名的一个例子是 Chandrakirti 世称菩萨世称，他呢所用的例子其实就是 一个水源处，譬如说我们讲一个池塘好了，就是这个水。以人类来讲，以人的业力因缘，他们看到的就是水可以解渴。但是如果我们讲的是天道，天道的众生，天界的这些天神，当他们看到这一处水源，他们看到的是什么？是甘露。但如果是恶鬼，恶鬼看到这个水源，他们其实看到的就是浓，就是那个你知道吗，血跟浓，很肮脏的。那这时候其实代表的是什么？其实这个水不是真实存在的，没有真正这个水的东西，它其实就是因为有情众生不同的这种业力因缘合，他们见到了不同的一个现象。所以说我们人类，我们看到了可以解渴的水，天神看到的是甘露，那恶鬼看到的就是血跟浓。所以说一切的运作就是类似这样的一个法则。我们可以看到外面这些建筑物，其实那是因为我们的业力。那么没有那样的一个业力因缘的众生，他其实就见不到这个建筑物的存在。但我们真正的问题就是，我们会觉得我们所看到的一切是真实存在的，这会是我们的一个弱点，也是一个问题。所以为什么我们要去净化业力，就是因为这样子。
Yes, so so we say all thisthings that we see, right? Table, water, everything is our, we see it because we have our causes, karmic causes and condition to see that table and chair, water, right? But now some people might think, oh, how about Buddha? So Buddha doesn't see anything, right? Because Buddha have no karma, right? He already cleared away all those karma. So Buddha don't see table,Buddha don't see water, he doesn't see a moon. Now this question might appear. Now, when you look, when the reason why we see, right, all those objects, right, for us, what are the causes and conditions is our own karma, right? Our karma is the causes and condition that allow us to see all those stuff. That's why anything that appears,out of karmic cause and condition is impure, understand? Because karma is something that we have to expel, remove, but we are not being able to remove that karma, so that karma force us to see so many different things, right? All those impure perceptions. Now Buddha is not like that. Buddha and Bodhisattva, they don't have karmic causes and condition because they clear away all those karmic causes and condition, but they still see a table,they still see a water. How? Because out of compassion and wisdom. For us, the fuel was the karma, right? But for them, fuel is not a karma. Fuel is wisdom and compassion. Because fuel, understand fuel?
Petrol,
gas, right? So for the Buddha and Bodhisattva, they don't have karma, but they have wisdom and, we call it Samyak Milam.Which is like pure prayers and pure compassion, limitless compassion. Out of that, they see all those things. Understand? So see these things is not only out of karmic condition. Right? It can also, you can see out of wisdom and prayers and, right? So out of those, right, you see.So, but these are not the impure perception, these are pure perception. So these are the different things.
That 刚刚人们在讲，他说为什么我们要净化一切的业力，就是因为我们要能够有一份静观，静观。那么为什么我们可以看到这些桌子、水、椅子，其实就是因为因缘的合，因为我们有这样的业力，我们就见到了一切的现象。那么诸佛菩萨，其实他们业力已经清净了，对吗？难道他们就没有办法看到所有这一切吗？像我们所看到的这些水啊，他们是不是就看不到桌子啊、水啊、月亮啊？我们看到显像对境，因为我们自身的一个业力因缘，然后我们看到了这一切。 那因为我们的业力是有染污的，因为我们的不净业、不净观，我们所以看到了所有这一切。这也就是为什么我们必须要去清净我们的业力，我们要去清净我们所见到的这一切显像。其实我们要必须要知道，它是基于我们的业力，是怎么讲，就是不净观，它不是一个清净最清净层面的一个显像。但是佛菩萨是怎么一回事呢？他们还是可以看到桌子跟水跟月亮的，为什么？因为他们的智慧跟他们的慈悲，其实因为他们的大智跟大悲，就是比如说我们刚刚讲 OK， 为什么同样的东西有情众生看起来的是水，然后有些看起来的比如说就像油，它其实就是石油，但是对其他有情众生，他可能看到哦就是水。这是代表就是每一个有情众生，他们因为自身不同的业力，看到不同的一个对境。但佛菩萨因为他们清净的大悲跟大智，他们其实也同样可以见到所有这一切显现。然后我们是因为我们有这些业力，我们看到所有这一切，所以很重要的，为什么要去清净业力？我们必须要有一个清净的感知。
Yes, so what are the benefit of having wisdom, you know? So why empty? So what is the benefit of seeing everything is emptiness? Because the reason why we have this desire, right, to get something, to buy something, is because we don't think it is emptiness. We think it's real. That's why we buy, right? If you think, oh, this mobile, iPhone 12 is fake, it's not real, do you think you will pay 30,000 Taiwan dollar? We will never pay, right? We pay because we think it's real. You know, I must marry with that woman. Because why? She's real. If you think, you know, she's fake, if she everything is she's emptiness, if we think she doesn't, nobody can see her, but only I can see, then do you think you will marry? No, you will not marry, because it's not real, right? So the wisdom of emptiness, you know, the reason why it is so important for us to have is that the reason why we attach, why we desire all those stuff is because we have the sense of belief that, oh, it is real, it is there, right? So because of that, because of things being real, we have a desire, then we do something, then we have created a karma, right? And all those things happen afterward. So what the benefit of the wisdom is seeing things, or if it is empty, then the desire is much less, right? It depends on wisdom, you know, how deep or how pure, strong your wisdom is. Depends on your own wisdom, things will be different, right? So yeah, that's the benefit. The reason why we love, the reason why we desire, is because we think it is there. So as soon as when we think it is not there, desire will be less intensive. That's the reason why we must learn understanding of emptiness.
拥有智慧，它能够带给我们什么样的利益跟好处呢？其实如果你真的去知道一切事物的本质是空性的，你很相对的，你的欲望就会降低。如果我们觉得一切都是真实存在的，都是真的，我们其实就会产生一种我要得到什么，我要买什么，我们就会有这样的一个欲望需求。而而且用他自己的手机，他说你看这个 iPhone 12最新的，如果你知道它，如果你把它看成你知道它不是真实存在，这个 iPhone 12其实是假的、虚幻的，你会花13000块去买这个 iPhone 12吗？其实是不会的，你也不会去花这个钱，对吗？然后你想想，哦，可能就想，哇，那个女人太美好了，我一定要娶到她。但如果你真的知道，其实那个女人不是真实存在，本质是空性的， 然后甚至你想，甚至你了知，只有你见到他是那个样子的时候，他不是那么真实的，你会这么执着说一定要取到他吗？所以说，为什么讲空性的智慧是很重要的？空性的智慧是非常重要，我们必须要去培养。其实就是因为我们没有这样一份空性的智慧，我们就会有很强的那种欲望直取的这样的驱动。因为在我们的感知来讲，我们觉得一切都是很真实，而且我们很相信，我们真的是信以为真，觉得一切就是这样子在运作，所以我们有这样的一个欲望，然后我们有这样的一个追求，然后大家都知道一切就这样发生了。其实就是因为我们不知道，我们没有这样一份空性的智慧，当我们有的时候，我们去培养它，我们很自然而然的，我们的欲求都会降低，然后我们会越来越依赖我们的这一份智慧，我们看事物的观点也会有所不同，我们的所有的这些爱、这些渴求跟这些欲望都会不断的减轻，因为我们很清楚明白，这一切并不是真实存在的。所以这就是为什么我们要能够去学习了知空性。
Yeah, so when you pay like, sand by one, ma. Sand by one, three million, is it 3 million?
Yes, 3 million.
3 million, 4 million, and buy a car, right? And somebody just scratch your car, right? Then done, 完蛋，对不对？Really, so the reason why it hurts so much is because, you know, this car means so much to you, because you really think, you know, this car is real, this car is everything for me, right? So at the end, right, for all those problems appear because we have this dualistic mind, seeing things, oh, that's there, that's not there, all those grasping.That's why, you know, when you have visaya, right? When you have grasping, you don't have the true wisdom. You know, when, right? So this is why, understand? So that's why it's very important for us to understand that everything is emptiness. It means that don't be so attached to the samsara, attached to your life. Everything doesn't exist. Truly doesn't exist. But as I say, right?Form is emptiness, and emptiness is form, right? So it means that it is Buddha not saying it's not there. Everything is here, but the true nature is not as we think it is, which we think it is real, but it is not real. It's not there, right? It looks very real to us. It appears very real to us, but it is not real. Understand? This is why we have to.It's important for us to have this wisdom.
如果你真的知道一切事物不是真实存在，但是接下来我们先讲 OK， 我们因为现在其实就是会有这种倾向，我们觉得一切事物真实存在，我们花了大概300万或者说400万，我们去买了一辆新车，然后忽然呢，有人不小心刮到了你的车。哇，那个当下真的是完蛋了，不知道是对方完蛋还是你心里觉得哦天哪，完蛋了，就真的是很痛，对吗？这个车这么贵耶。但是如果你真的了知，知道空性，其实你就会发现啊，这车也不是真实的，它其实也不是真的是一切，它不是像我之前觉得说哦，这车是我的一切，然后这么的痛。你真的有这份空性的智慧呢，你其实就会发现一切的问题都会降低，你也不会有那么多的麻烦，因为所有的一切来自我们这种能所恶别的心，这种恶缘执着的心。我们见到哦，那个真的在那边，然后那个东西这个东西，但是如果说我们真的能够了知一切的显象，这只是一个显象，它的本质是空性的，我们就不会对这个轮回、对此生这么的执着。这也就是为什么之前的第四句偈颂文殊所说的若有执着非智慧，当我们有智慧的时候，你很自然而然的，你的这份执着就会降低，因为你很清楚一切不是真实存在的，色即是空， 空即是色。所以佛陀他不是在告诉大家说这一切都不是真实，这一切都没有在那边，有，他是说有的，一切都在，它是都显现的，但是空即是色，色即就是它是一切都是显现，但它却不是真实真实真正的实有存在的。所以说我们必须要去学习了知，去拥有这一份空性的智慧。
So now the most important thing, right, is that now you might think, oh, now dualistic mind is the source of all problem, right? Now we have to remove this dualistic mind. Now how should we remove dualistic mind, right? Now Shantideva said, oh, don't remove dualistic mind. He said, dungal nyevar shidundu dibi mumba domicha, right? Now I say, oh, wisdom very important. Dualistic mind is all of the source of all the problem. Now you all of you think, oh, now we have how to remove dualistic mind, right? Shantideva say, oh, don't remove dualistic mind. It is very useful for us right now. Really. Right now we cannot remove dualistic mind. It's not possible. So he said, in order to free oneself from suffering, or believing that Buddha is here, Dharma is here, Sangha is here, trust in that, which is also a wrong view, but for time being is very useful. So don't instantly think about removing those wrong views. For time being, that ignorance, the wrong view, is also very useful. But eventually, you have to remove. So what he's really meaning, right? Right now, you don't bother about dualistic mind. Have dualistic mind, use. Right, believe that there is a God, believe there is a Buddha, Dharma, Sangha, right? And practice. Believe there is a compassion, believe there is a path, believe there is a path to enlightenment. Believe that. It will be very useful. So don't think about removing the dualistic mind instantly. It won't be helpful, he said.
那么在现在呢，我们要讲最重要的。我们听到目前为止呢，大家可能就会想说，哦，那这个二别心就是一切问题的来源，我必须要去移除它，我应该要怎么样移除我这种自他这种能属的这种二别心。齐天菩萨其实就是说，不用，现在请先不要去专注在怎么样进化，就是移除这个二别心。因为人们界刚刚讲了那么多，智慧是多么多么的重要，然后二别心是怎么样带来麻烦，然后大家就想我怎么样来移除这个二别心。但是其实在线下，在对我们现在来讲，我们必须要了知佛法僧三宝是很重要的，这是我们要去依赖的，这是我们要去信任的，我们不要去移除他们。同样的，我们的执着在现在来讲其实有好的一个层面，因为刚刚讲说若有执着非智慧，其实你只要有任何执着，那就是一种错误的见地，因为就表示我们不了解空性。但是它在对我们现在这个阶段来讲，它是很重要的，我们必须要去深信是的，是有天有神有三宝，然后慈悲是很重要的，这条法道是很重要的，我们需要去修持佛法。现在我们必须要依赖这样一个二别心，然后来进行这个修持之道。
Yes, so but every day, right, but Shantideva, he didn't mean that or don't practice non-dualistic practices. He didn't say that. So what he said, we can practice. But for time being, it won't make a lot of sense, right? Because we really think our car, our wife, our husband, our children is very real, right? Right. So instantly we cannot say, oh, 都是空空的，没有用。我们不相信啊，我们不会相信。这个还 OK, 没问题。 But what Chandradeva said, what all those masters said, that right now is not very useful, but every day spend some time thinking about it, right? And looking at all those creation as emptiness. Every day. Maybe 2 minutes, 3 minutes. You know, even though right now it doesn't make a lot of sense, but if you keep thinking like this for many, many time, one day it will become your habit. Right? When it become your habit, it is quite close to wisdom. Understand? So when it becomes your habit, someone scratch your car, it won't be that bad, really. You can still have some patience over that. Oh, it's emptiness. There won't be much strong desire to protect your car, right? So it's very important. So what I say is, you know, usually I say fake it until you make it. Even though right now it doesn't make sense, but you just fake it. You just every day you do it. You know, think about your husband, your children, your house as an emptiness. Just fake it. One day you will make it. Understand? So when you make it, what I mean is it become your habit. 习惯. When it becomes your habit, that's the wisdom. You know, it's quite close to the wisdom. Right? So don't think about removing at all at once, but always think. Spend some time thinking about emptiness. One day it will become your habit. So when it becomes your habit, it's quite close to your wisdom. Yeah.
那么吉天菩萨，所以他说现在现下 我们还不用完全去移除这个恶别心，但是他所谓的意思也不是说我们不用去亲近这样的一个恶缘恶别的心，他其实意思就是说，你知道我们每天当中。 我们会觉得 OK， 我们看到的一切都是真实的，我们的车啊，我们的伴侣啊，你如果现在说哦，这一切都是假的，我不会相信的，这个老公也是假的，车也是假的，你其实必须要说，这个对我们线下的生活没有那么有帮助。但是我们还是必须要去练习的，怎么练习呢？我们先说，我们可以每天花2到3分钟。 我们真的去醒思、去思考，其实所有我们周遭的这一切，它只是一个显像，它其实就是一个像而已，它就是虚幻，本质是虚幻的。你如果每天就是花2、3分钟，你这样子去思考、这样去修持，慢慢慢慢的，你会培养出这样的一份习惯。当你培养起这样的一份习惯，它其实就已经很接近智慧了。所以说。 其实就会知道说，OK。当有人刮伤了你的车，你会知道哦，其实那个车不是真实存在的。你这时候就不会那么的痛，你就不会有那么强的欲望跟这种保护欲。然后你在这当中，你其实就会有一份空间。所以仁波切他讲说，假酒成真。你现在就是先去假装，也不是，你就是先去练习。 你去练习，假装你就是每天去思考。OK， 这一切不是那么真实的。慢慢慢慢之后，你会对你的伴侣、你的房子、你的车子，就会开始不那么的执着。你会开始去习惯这样的一个念头：哦，其实他们本质是空性的。当你有这样的习惯，它已经很接近智慧了。其实你这时候已经在慢慢的移除的你的这种恶别心。 所以说你去思考，去思考，你这样子去练习空性，然后之后你就养成习惯，那再来你就会有智慧。
Yeah, I think we are already very late. So today, right, we talk about a fraction, you know, very small part of wisdom, and we still have 2 more session, right? So maybe next 2 session we will talk about wisdom a little bit. As much as we can, right? But today I just try to give you a glimpse of what we Buddhists mean as an emptiness. Okay, so that's about it. So next session, I
want to talk about this 12 interdependent link, is it? Because, because it's very important, as we say, we want to talk about those karma, right? For karma, 12 interdependent link is very important. So next session, we will talk about it. Okay, so thank you very much.
那么今天仁波切他其实就是稍微就智慧谈了一些层面，那么接下来的课他可以说今天大家他就是带大家稍微去见识一下，你对智慧有所一瞥，你稍微看到了 OK 什么是佛法所谓的智慧。然后接下来这一堂，接下来的下礼拜那一堂课呢，他更会就是会深入智慧，同时呢他要讲的那个一个主要主题就是十二因缘。十二因缘在讲解业力是非常重要的一个教法，所以这是他会着重的。那今天时间已经晚了，所以他说谢谢大家，今天就到此为止。
Thank you.